Mods are hands down one of the coolest things about PC gaming. Now, 99% of console games are restricted to play one way or another. Many PC games let you pretty much do whatever you want with a game as long as you know what you're doing. But with that being said, some people definitely go above and beyond what you probably expect. What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Welcome to Chaos Top 10s, and today we're going to go over my picks for 10 outrageous video game mods that got everybody's attention for one reason or another. And be sure to let me know in the comment section what mod you like to play with if you're a PC player and on what game. Drop a like and let's get into this list. At number 10, the Stupidity mod in Return to Castle Wolfenstein. Now, this is a mod for the classic FPS game Return to Castle Wolfenstein, released all the way back in 2001. This was an alternate history game that had you playing in a world where the regime won the Second World War, and it was up to you to try and bring justice and peace back to the world. The concept and the art style is pretty grounded and serious and dark, but you wouldn't be able to tell that with this specific mod. The Stupidity mod not only makes the game insanely colorful and bright, but it also changes a lot of the characters and sound effects into random memes and pop culture references. This mod gets very, very obnoxious really fast, but I think that was kind of the point. So here it is at number 10 on our list today. Next up, we have the Pedestrian Riot in GTA 5. Now, Grand Theft Auto 5 is chocked full of great mods for UD. Honestly, it's almost an infinite list of them, okay? And it adds such a layer of replayability to the game, and it's pretty entertaining. One of the most entertaining ones is the Pedestrian Riot mod. One thing about GTA 5 that's a little disappointing at times is the fact that the police are the only NPCs who will actually attack you back, and random civilians won't ever do anything to you, even if you are straight punching them in the face while their friend is standing right next to you. Well, if you want to turn GTA 5 into a total brawler, install the Pedestrian Riot mod. This mod will alter the AI of every NPC in the game to be extremely aggressive to both you and the other NPCs, turning the game into a total cluster in the best possible way. GTA 5 is definitely more interesting when the pedestrians you're terrorizing are not afraid to actually fight back. At number 8, I don't know if this is great or horrible, Nicolas Cage in Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask. Now, I don't know. This probably makes hardcore Nintendo fans cringe on a whole nother level. Nicolas Cage is kind of a meme at this point, and that's the whole point of this mod. Majora's Mask is one of the greatest games of all time, and it's definitely not a game where you'd expect something so comical to be around. But here it is. The Nicolas Cage mod will take the face of the famous actor and stretch it onto every character model's head, turning everybody in the game into Nick. Now, why would you want to do this, you may ask? Well, I don't have that answer for you. I don't know who had the first idea and actually made it work. I really don't know. But here it is, and it's definitely deserving of a spot on today's list. At number 7, we have Waluigi in Dragon Ball FighterZ. Now, leading up to the release of Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, thousands of fans were trying to get Waluigi added as a playable fighter. It makes sense, but unfortunately, their efforts were unsuccessful and he is not part of the game. So instead of settling for Smash, some modders decided to add the famed Nintendo character to a different fighting game. The Waluigi mod for Dragon Ball Z adds Waluigi into the game as a skin for Super Saiyan Blue Vegeta, and it doesn't change any of the voice lines, but it is definitely fun to see Waluigi beating up on some famous characters like Goku, Android 18, and just many, many more. If you have Dragon Ball FighterZ on PC and you've been itching to play as Waluigi in a fighting game for some rare reason, definitely check out this mod. This month's giveaway is for a brand new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is like the video, make sure you're subscribed to the channel, turn on those notifications, and tweet me why you want to win it with your Twitter handle included. Number 6, we have Alchemilia in Half-Life 2. Now, this is actually a very amazing mod, as you probably know. Some mods will simply change certain details in a game, while other mods will completely transform the game into something new. And that is where this mod comes in. Alchemilia is a mod for Half-Life 2 that completely transforms the game into a survival horror game inspired by Silent Hill 2. It features a full story, new characters, and while there aren't any monsters in it, it features some of the creepiest atmosphere and sound design I've ever seen in a fan-made game. If you're someone who has been looking for a good Silent Hill-style game, but you've been upset because Silent Hills got canceled, definitely look into the Alchemilia mod for Half-Life 2. It will hold you over for at least a little while, and it's literally like you're playing a brand new game within a game. Cracking into the top five today, we have Pokestein 3D and Wolfenstein 3D. Back to the Wolfenstein mods. It was released back in 92, and it helped pave the way for the future of first-person shooters. But given how simple the game is, it's made extremely easy for modders to take advantage, and since became one of the most modded games ever. This particular mod, the Pokestein 3D, takes a very strange twist on the established game. Now, as you know, Wolfenstein is a series about shooting the regime, but the Pokestein 3D mod will turn all those bad guys into evil versions of Pikachu and other famous Pokemon. There's honestly something unsettling about seeing cute Pokemon dressed up like the regime and running around trying to murder you. But then again, that's the point of this list. It's crazy. At number four, Macho Man Randy Savage in Skyrim. Now, Skyrim is another one of the most heavily modded games of all time, and much of that is thanks to how open Bethesda has been about letting people alter their games for years, which is really cool. There have probably been thousands upon thousands of mods made for Skyrim since its release, but here's one of my favorites. The Macho Man Randy Savage mod will transform Alduin, the giant dragon who serves as the game's antagonist, into a giant version of Randy Savage, who is a famous professional wrestler, if you didn't know. And instead of roaring like the dragon normally would, Randy will scream inspirational speeches at you or yell things like, "Oh yeah," as he tries to kill you. I want you guys to let me know in the comments. Would you rather be hunted down by a giant dragon or a giant version of Macho Man Randy Savage? This is literally one of the best mods ever created in gaming history. Okay, at number three, this is pretty straightforward. I'm going to keep it PG-13, but Sonic in Sonic Generations as a certain piece. Okay, it's pretty straightforward, all right? No twist, no hidden meaning. He's literally a body part, okay? I have no idea whose idea it was. I don't really know if I want to meet him, and I think we're just going to move on. At number two, the immersive indigestion in Skyrim. One universal rule of the planet Earth is that farts are funny, and they will always be deemed funny, okay? So what better way to improve Skyrim than to make everybody fart all the time? Just one infinite fart fest in the video game world, right? The immersive indigestion mod will make it so every once in a while, the character will randomly burp and fart in order to make the world more immersive, because it does. It makes the world more immersive. It makes you feel like you're in there. You can smell it. You can almost taste it. Now, according to the modder, he even recorded some of the sound effects himself. And I wonder how long it took him to get the perfect fart. And you know what? That is going the extra mile. Not only modding a game, but taking the time to put in your own flatulence. I mean, this guy deserves an award. He deserves a major award. I don't know what kind, but he does. And at number one today, guys, we have Psionic Warfare, Total Destruction in StarCraft II. Finishing off this amazing list today is another total game changer mod. And this time, we're turning our attention to StarCraft II, the famous RTS game, into a full-fledged third-person shooter. Psionic Warfare takes the assets and the models of StarCraft II and creates this fully playable third-person shooter complete with different maps and game modes for everybody to enjoy. StarCraft is a huge universe that many people love, so naturally people are going to want to try and experience that universe in new ways. But this mod goes way, way above and beyond what I think anybody was ever expecting. Psionic Warfare Total Destruction is an amazing mod, and it's definitely worth a try if you're a fan of StarCraft II but have been looking for something new in that universe. You do need to try this. There's a reason that I put it at the number one spot today. So you guys, let me know what you think about it, and there you go. Those are 10 outrageous video game mods, 10 awesome video game mods that I suggest you guys all try. Let me know in the comment section some mods that I missed. We can do another part of this. We can do 10 parts of this. There's so many cool video game mods out there in the universe. If you guys enjoyed the video, take a second, make sure you're subscribed, drop a like, and then turn on those notifications. Check the box, click the bell, because that's YouTube's mod way of trying to get it to where you get my videos. And hopefully you do. I hope you guys have a great night, and I'll see you soon. Thank you.